Virtuality. Now we're going to move on to connection, and we're going to, as we always do, start with another clip from popular culture.
What's this?
This is the code that I've written for our year-to-year projections. This is building in all the intelligence that we have to project players.
Okay.
It's about getting things down to one number. Using stats the way we read them, we'll find value in players that nobody else can see. People are overlooked for a variety of biased reasons and perceived flaws. Age, appearance, personality. Bill James and mathematics cut straight through that. Billy, of the 20,000 notable players for us to consider, I believe that there is a championship team of 25 people that we could afford, because everyone else in baseball undervalues them. Like an island of misfit toys.
So Alex, this third trend around connection is strongly linked to the previous two. We just saw a clip from the movie Moneyball. Can you explain what that has to do with HR in the workplace in 2021?
Moneyball is a great HR lesson in itself, and in particular for recruiters. In two words, what the movie is showing is that the name of the game now, it's not about hiring and gathering people that match with the criteria that are commonly accepted. In the movie, it's five criteria that are followed by all the baseball teams in the league. It comes back to the humility point, because if we say, I don't know, and if we've got to find answers, answers will be found together, will require collaboration more than ever. We claimed that for years with the digital transformation, but now is the time, because we won't be able to find solution alone, because no one here in the humankind will have learned a solution, a pre-existing solution somewhere. So solutions have got to be invented, and as once we were saying in a TED, innovations comes from ideas having sex. And ideas have got to come from different angles, different lights, different minds. And that's what the Moneyball movie is all about. It's all about stopping hiring stars, top performers, because they won't have a solution. There will be no individual heroes anymore. It's all about bringing people together that, because of their diversity, because of their differences, when you assemble them together, you got a team. And you got the ground to create new stuff, the stuff that we need today. And if you just take the illustration of this webinar, this is the first time of my life that I'm recording the HR trends this way. We are both of us in a room here in Paris. The other are with Zoom at home. And yet, there is something. There is a ground to communicate. Why? Because we took just the time, the necessary time before, to get to know each other. I believe it would have been extremely complicated to start from scratch without knowing who is Debra, who is Robindro. So we kind of organized this event in a way where eventually, and I hope it's the case for you, which are at home or maybe at the office too, I hope there is emotion. Here, something is going on. I love the way we can jump in on discussions and so on. So what I believe in is that you can still create connections in this digital world. I believe that connections are the only way to create the solutions that we will need in the coming years. And I believe it's, in a way, a good news, because I believe there is no fun in doing things alone anywhere. You see that in sports, in art, in your personal life. I see no reason why it would be the case at work. And yet, so many people have been used to work alone and to be the hero by themselves. And if they were asking for help, it was almost a weakness. We've got to change this mindset too.
Neely, we're talking about different themes around connection like getting to know your employees better and actually creating stronger connections with your colleagues. Do you have reflections on that?
Yes, I think complete sense for organizations to create stronger connections with the people that work within them, but also for employees to create stronger connections between them, especially now in these times where so many of us are working alone from our home. I think what becomes more and more important is to feel this sense of connection with your colleagues, as well as with the company that you work for. This is what Alex actually said. It doesn't make sense to do all the work by yourself and to be afraid to ask for help. I think along the same lines, it doesn't make sense to not have a connection, a stronger connection, both with your colleagues and with the organization you work for.
And Rabindro, we've already touched on how connection can relate to recruiting, especially in this Moneyball example. But in your experience, how is it changing the ways that organizations are recruiting?
For me, from my point of view, it's also a topic of, for example, culture fit. Yeah, if people are connecting more easily if they have a culture fit, like you just said it, we had a pre-meeting and I think we have a very similar mindset, so we connected easily. And in the way how people recruit, at least in Germany, they are more and more using data-driven tools to measure this cultural fit, to have some kind of cultural basis they can build on the recruitment process. In Germany, we have good example from NGOs who are already started, because for them, this fit and this connection with the people is crucial for their work.
Deborah, I just want to come to you as well. I believe that you've looked into what's called social connections. Can you tell us a bit more about what that is about and share some examples from companies you've worked with?
Yeah, I recently wrote a blog on social connections, and so I did a little bit of research on it. So the first piece of trivial information I wanted to share with you is from a report that says that social connections are as important to your well-being as eating your vegetables, exercising, and getting enough sleep. And I don't actually think that you'd be surprised by that. If you think about how important those social connections are with your friends, your family, and your colleagues, it really can brighten up your day and help your emotional and mental well-being. So as you said, companies are doing tons of work when it comes to that. I've got a whiteboard, it's too big to put in front of the screen, with post-its of all the amazing things that companies are doing, because people know that I like to share stories, so they write to me their stories. And it's just been really, really creative. And what companies are finding is they need to find ways to connect with everyone, not just the type of people who will join in and do an online talent competition or online dance-a-thon or something like that. They're really trying to touch different groups of people. One of my favorite examples is a company told me that they had some employees who are a bit on the OCD parameter, and that during lockdown, they had cleaned every single piece of furniture and every ledge in their house, and they were getting a bit bored. So they volunteered to do a cleaning challenge for the rest of their employees. And they came on and they gave these lessons on how to clean. And then they had a competition. And I think it's just a lovely example of bringing people together in different ways. So yeah, really, really important to do this more so than ever before.
Just finally for you, Alex, one thing I was thinking is, what does this change in terms of the way we look at teams in an organization?
Real teams, you mean, not Microsoft Teams? Oh, sorry, this is the kind of joke of 2021 now, I'm sorry for that. What is changing is that we've got to think on a more global level. It means that it's not about now just what I want, what I need. We have talked a lot about the customization of relationships, for instance, between the manager and the employee. Actually, what is changing right now is that you got to put in a way the interest of the team before your own interest. Just talking about the remote work. Some of us want to go remote forever. Some of us want to go back to the office. And if you combine all these ambitions, constraints, wishes. At the end, for a manager, for HR, it's impossible to deal with that. What's got to change is that, obviously, we got to keep up with our wishes and constraints. But we got to put the team interest, I believe, first and say, if I stay at home today, is it a problem for my team or not? Because if it is a problem, there is a very thin line between keeping up with my constraints and becoming selfish. So it's about this balance. It comes back to education. And what I say is very cultural, because obviously it will be different from one country to another. So if we think collectively, think about the team interest first, and we have a manager that tries to combine the individual constraints, keeping this team objective first, I'm absolutely sure that there is a way where all the problems we are struggling with right now are going to be solved. I believe it's a very important key.
I absolutely agree. And I think that more so than ever, it goes back to that humility in being human, is we need to get to understand the entire person. So what are the different challenges? What are the obstacles that everybody has? You know, before the call, we were all making apologies. Okay, I've got a dog sleeping over there. I've got a cat over here. I've got a husband working upstairs. And I think the more that we collectively, not just leaders in HR, take the time to get to know each other and support each other, I think the better that we'll be able to overcome exactly what you've spoken about. But that change needs to happen.
So connection was a third trend that we see for HR and the workplace in 2021.